She has been our fabulous guest host all morning, and now it is time for an in-depth chat with the fabulous Fiona O'Loughlin. And you've got a new book and a really big show this weekend. Speaking of your book, you really talk about some of your demons.
Yeah, it was so lovely to write because when you... I'm a very autobiographical stand-up, but you paint everything with a big, broad brush, you know, for the laughs. And it was so lovely to be able to feel it, like, to tell a story without... I mean, it is very funny in parts and then it's sad and not just, you know, it's not a me fest. I got to really, like, talk about the love I had for lost relations and not missing...
You call it me of the never-never.
Yeah.
What do you mean by that title? Is it because it's in the Northern Territory?
Yeah, and, you know, a play on She of the Never Never. Mm. But I really... You know, Alice Springs, as much as I love it, it's the landscape that my children grew up in, but it only ever felt tenuously like home for me.
Right.
You know, and...
Which is why you left.
And there are some pictures of...
Oh, look at them! That's Henry and Tess in the middle and Biddy.
Oh, some of your beautiful kids. And you...
Gee, I got lucky, though, didn't we? Like...
Aren't they gorgeous?
That man I married made good babies.
And you've been incredibly...
We're separated now, quite amicably, until he sees this show.
But in this book, but also... on Australian Story recently, you've been very open about your battles with alcoholism.
Yeah.
And also how times when you got terribly low and, you know, there were times when you thought about taking your life.
Yeah.
That's a huge thing to share with a lot of people.
Yeah.
Why was it something that you thought, I need to tell people about this?
I guess because I have a guilt of my own. I had a very sick alcoholic uncle and I had no compassion for him. I just thought, what an idiot. Stop drinking, you know. And he died never finding recovery. Mm-hmm. And then I think there's so much... it's kind of... Oh, it's hard to explain. Being a female and a mother alcoholic, you're called on it earlier. Mm. You know, and I'm grateful for that. Even though there's more shame attached to it, I think it's easier for a woman to find recovery because I know a lot of men who are so close to alcoholism.
But it's not easy, is it? It's not easy, Fiona. How low did you go?
Oh, I went all the way to, you know, I took an overdose and the last thing I said to my Lord and Maker was, if you send me to hell, you're an asshole. Those were my last words.
And are you sober now?
Yeah. And oh God, I hope forever.
Mm. Yeah. But it's a battle, isn't it? I mean, alcoholism is an illness.
Yeah.
It's not something that someone chooses, or you know, it is a struggle.
And also, I mean, it's when you're as bad as I was, like, and I have lived in Alice Springs for 27 years, and what I'd love to say to people is, because we see alcoholism daily, like, and you can judge that, but the party's over. Do you know what I mean? Like, people drinking at that level, as I was, are in agony. Mm. Like, so...
What sort of level was it, Fiona? Like, was it all day?
How bad?
No, I would disappear. I didn't drink at home. So when I go back to Alice Springs, I used to call it the Betty Ford Clinic. But it would be something I would do in... Like, I would just disappear for 3 days.
Go on a bender on my own
in the hotel room. Always end up in an ambulance.
And obviously with...
My preferred mode of transport.
With the death of Robin Williams, there's been all this sort of talk about whether or not there's some kind of link between depression or substance abuse and being a comedian, whether, you know, needing to find ways to laugh at things is a way of kind of self-medicating if you're depressed, or whether there's a link between, you know...
I think there is... like a lot of comedians, I mean, you've got to be barking mad to do it in the first place. Obviously. But also there's, I think a lot of comedians are broken.
Yeah.
People in a way, and that's, you know...
Yeah, well, laughter's a good way of coping with a life that is broken.
But also an alcoholic suicide, because I know I nearly took myself... You know, I went as close as you can come. Mm. What I would love to say to people, it's such a waste, because basically what I was doing, and this is as honest as I can be, I'd made such a mess, I had no idea how to clean it up.
Mm. But your kids helped you, didn't they, Tess?
Yeah, but when... Yeah, and I can't speak for other types of suicide, but if I could tell anyone that there's no mess that you can't help get.
Mm. Yes, there is a way.
It's so selfish.
You can find a way through.
Like, oh, man, oh well, I'll disappear. Mm. See you all.
So tell us about your show that you're going to do.
My show.
Yeah, the new show you're going to do.
Yeah, I'm just. Change an overdose on stage. Yeah. No, I'm kidding. this show is called My Brilliant Career. It's just five stories, really, of five of my favourite stories of being on the road for 15 years.
And you have some stories, my goodness me. You're such a woman.
I wonderful. Just love a story. I love it. Thanks.
Well, you are a brilliant woman. You're very, very funny. I think also just women in general are able to relate to you and the struggles you've been through. Fiona's book, Me of the Never Never, excuse me, is available now. And she's also in the Just for Laughs Festival in Sydney until Sunday. You can check out all the details at sydneyoperahouse.com/justforlaughs.
Yeah, and of course, if you're... And then, of course, if you are struggling, there is help out there. The usual places, Beyond Blue, Lifeline. You can always clean up the mess, don't you worry.
Yeah.
Oh, thanks, Joe. Yeah.